You have to have hope. Without hope, I don't know how I would have gotten to this day. I'm Alicia Bisher. I'm from Fort Worth, Texas. I had surgery last July 2017. I developed a blood clot in my spine and I became an incomplete paraplegic. When someone can't tell you 100% that you're going to get that feeling back, it's terrifying. It's terrifying. When I woke up from surgery, I couldn't feel my legs. That was the first thing I said to my husband. I told my surgeon, get me into Texas Rehab Hospital. This is where I'm going to get the best care. And what I found is that there are wonderful therapists, wonderful physicians. Everybody offers you hope. I came in last year. I was paralyzed, and now I can walk with the help of a walker. And my goal is to get out of my wheelchair. The Ekso is very different from any other therapy. We do mat exercises, we do standing exercises, I do walking exercises, but the Ekso is different because it actually gave me the feeling of walking again, and nothing else could do that. I was standing, I had my feet on the floor, and my legs were moving. It's hard to find hope when you're in the depths of despair, and the Ekso gave me hope. I feel like I've come full circle. I left here not walking, and I'm gonna walk out of this building when I go home next week.
My granddaughter is 8 years old. She is everything to me. That's part of why I will work as hard as I have to, is because I don't want her having a Mimi that can't take her places and do things with her. I had gone into the surgery center to have a spinal injection, and when I woke up, I couldn't feel my legs. I couldn't move my feet. I couldn't move my legs. I knew that I was gonna have to go to rehab. That was pretty obvious. And I checked around with a few people and they said this was a great rehab.
From the beginning, this hospital's been focused on quality. We wanna be able to, you know, treat the patients that are from here, be able to offer them the most functional improvement, grow our programs to where we can fulfill any need that comes across. So we've gone through and gotten special accreditations in brain injury and stroke. We're pursuing one now in spinal cord injury. That's a service that we feel like we're giving back to the community, and that's kind of been our mission from the beginning.
Here at Texas Rehab, obviously, we're just focusing on mobility, you know, and improving people's functional safety. And our outcomes over our inception have been, you know, exceptional and top 1% of the nation. And it's cutting edge pieces of equipment and obviously excellent staff that are focusing on neuro recovery that have helped spearhead that.
My physical therapist one day said, I think we might put you in Ekso. I didn't know what to expect from the Ekso. I loved the way it felt when it stood you up, because at that point in time I couldn't stand up by myself. It was sort of freeing to think that, okay, maybe if this can stand me up, I should be able to learn to hold myself up.
When Marty first came in, she had very minimal movement in her legs. It took two people to get her to stand. I think she walked 12 feet in the parallel bars initially. We measured her, put her in the device. The first time she walked probably 125 steps. And then we got her in again the next time and she walked 450 feet. She completely surpassed my expectations. She was doing so much work. She felt so great about it. She was here for just a little over 2 weeks and she left the facility walking with a walker over, you know, 400 feet.
I think the exoskeletons are excellent, you know, devices to kind of help assist what we naturally do with the patients anyway. It helps expedite the process and speed it up because we allow a greater range of motion and more flexibility in where we can perform these activities and to allow patients that true fluid range of motion that they wouldn't necessarily be able to provide with other devices.
Now, I think the biggest benefit from what I've seen with our clinicians is just the amount of repetitions that they're able to get in and the time it takes to get to that point. We want to maximize the time that we do have with them. So probably the biggest benefit has been the fact that we can get to that point sooner and get more time doing the things that we know are going to help that patient.
The thing that stood out the most about ExoGT for me was how much variability there was in it. It was being able to do variable assists, changing their resisted to no assist to free. There were just so many different options you could do, and I didn't see that with anything else. So when I was looking at what the future holds for all of these different devices, I definitely saw the Ekso being an outlier and that it was far more progressive than the others.
I would definitely recommend with any patients with spinal cord injury and stroke, utilize this equipment. And obviously, you know, here at Texas Rehab, we are very, very proud to have it and provide this service to our patient population.
I am very satisfied with the help I got here. If I had to put it this way, if I had to do this again for some reason, God forbid, I would come back here because of the rehab that I got. I'm not going to tell you it was easy because it wasn't. It was hard. There were several times that I thought, I just want to sit down, but I wasn't going to do that.
Upon discharge, she accomplished up to 300 feet with a rolling walker, and which was a remarkable gain for the time period that she had.
You know, I got to be honest, for me personally, if we're able to really be successful, whatever the metrics show, if they get to the point where they can go back to doing what they were doing before, then that's really what we're all about.
We played charades. Even when I was up here in the hospital, we played that heads-up game. At home, we did a scavenger hunt. So, I mean, I was having to go on my walker, you know, and on my feet and stuff, and we did that numerous times. But there's a lot more things that I have to do with her. So I have to keep working.